Where it is right now in the Senate, House, and the governor's races is very similar to where it's been, I think, for the last 6 months, basically. I mean, I think that Republicans are a slight favorite to win the Senate, and that at the moment, I think that, that their gains would be anywhere from 4 to 8 seats, with the likeliest outcome being 6 or 7. 6, of course, is the magic number for the Republicans to get to 51 seats. Just plus 5 would make the Senate 50-50, but that's not enough because Joe Biden would break ties, so Harry Reid would stay majority leader. So 6 is the magic number in the Senate. Republicans basically already have 3 seats in the bag. West Virginia, South Dakota, and Montana are all look very likely to go to the Republicans. Kentucky and Georgia, which are Republican seats, are still, you know, very, very close at this point, even though I think Republicans have a small edge in those seats. So, again, 4 to 8 plus Republican in the Senate, which would be very much in keeping with how, you know, generally how the non-president's party does in a midterm year. You'd rather be out of the White House in a midterm year. The likeliest outcome is that the Republicans get a very slim Senate majority of 51 or 52 seats, which would be a net gain of 51 or a net gain of 6 or 7. I think that if Republicans just win a bare 6 based on this map, and really don't pick up a lot of House seats and sort of play even in the governor's races, I don't know if that's really a wave more than it is just a kind of an election sort of based on the unique circumstances of this year, which is that the Senate race is the Senate map is heavily tilted toward Republicans, and the environment is such that Republicans should probably do fairly well.